in pediatrics, where it's relevant, the virus and the bacteria are different in the illnesses that they cause, and then basically also the way that they're treated. Viruses are much more common than bacteria, especially in pediatrics. I would say 9 out of 10 times viruses are going to be what's causing your child's illness. Usually viruses are a little bit more like your typical cold if we're talking about more the respiratory illnesses. And with a virus, you could have a fever for, you know, 2, 3, 4 days, and then you typically have cough and congestion that can last, believe it or not, up to 2 weeks. And I think a lot of patients and parents are a little bit surprised by the fact that viruses can last so long, and they oftentimes get frustrated with that. So bacteria usually, when you're talking about a respiratory infection, it usually actually comes on the tail end of the virus. So you'll have the viral infection first, and instead of getting better after the 10-day to 2-week mark, you start getting worse again. You all of a sudden get a new fever, or you start having new symptoms develop, and that might be a sign of a bacterial infection. In some cases, you do start out with a bacteria, but those are more cases like skin infections. Sometimes other types of stomach infections may be more from a bacterial source, something that you ate that was contaminated with bacteria, per se. So viruses and bacteria are treated very differently. For bacteria, we almost always treat it with an antibiotic. There are a few circumstances where we don't need to use an antibiotic. With viruses, for the most part, we treat with what we call supportive care. So basically managing our symptoms, and the body usually takes care of it in about 10 to 14 days.